Finals day in the water polo. Hello and welcome to the pool at the Modern Pentathlon and Fencing Centre in Chengdu for the medal matches in the women's water polo. China, Italy is the gold showdown a little later. But up first, it's Japan, Australia for the bronze. No team has the authority to hold on to the ball for longer than 30 seconds in water polo. To get a shot away in that time. Ah, the handling was the issue there again. And through that middle once more. Just about enough on it defensively there from Saya Sakine. Now the opportunity. Both sides very reticent. That time it was Fujiwara pulled out to the left-hand side of that perimeter. It made it easy, really, for Pamp. Now, Australia driving on. That's the opener in this bronze medal matchup. A good piece of finishing. Camilla Mackay. A switch to the inside. Holsek finish a possibility here. No, it's a 2-on-1. A good defensive smothering there from those two Japan backline players. Looks like a foul has been called. Ordinary foul that time. Nice switch play. Oh! Well, we don't have own goals in water polo. So, number two here for Australia will be credited to Indigo Ditterick. That's over the line, isn't it? Excellent through ball. A clean through here. Saya Sakine just loses possession. It looks like 5 meter penalty here for Japan. It's Fujiwara against Pam. Bit of extra delay before the shot can be taken. Skids. Off the waves and up past Pam, and Japan here are in the game, 2-1. So Sakine gets forward, a major foul called there by the officials on Grace Coleman. Still 6v6. Only Marsh and Coleman on the entire roster here from both teams who are in danger. Great response from the Uni-Roos after conceding that swung home slingshot finish there across Saruka Inaba by Savannah Henshaw. Well, she got two against the Chinese in the semi-final. There you have it. 25% of the way there, the Australians, 3-1. Now there's a chance, it's Haruka Yamamoto who is clean through and could reduce the gap to one here. She does that, no chance, Pam. Really good play that by Japan. It's a clever ball back there to Haruka Inaba. She has the vision there to pick out the driver, Haruka Yamamoto. Nielsen's just finding their passing a little bit off at the moment. The ball over the top. Oh, this could be an opportunity. The goal is gaping. And we are 3-3 here. Australia's level has just come down. Lovely pass there by Takahashi. And this was unselfish from Kobayashi. Just switching it left there. There you have it. All square in the battle for bronze. Again, the shot clock's ticking. 6-5-4, has to be, great chance, not taken. Well, they will feel they should be back in the lead there. Just a difficult swing there by Indigo Ditterick, who's missed, and now straight away, Sakine at the other end, in it comes, that's nice and tidy. Finished by Fujiwara, denied her. Dayano Fujiwara of Shumei University. Inagawa, then to Takahashi, switches it across. No, ideally stationed there. It's Marsh now then, This has to go in to make it 4-4, and it does go in to make it 4-4. She got it right in the end. Indigo Ditterick, well played. And that's what brings the dividends. All square again here in the third quarter. On the reset, it's Australia. Lovely field there. Ditterick trying to get open and finishes. So the deadlock broken. It's two without reply here for Australia. Finish comes from Madison Powles. Clinically done. 5-4. Australia have the lead, but Japan still very much in this. Yamamoto gets a little closer, and Yamamoto finds the corner. It's gone in off the cage. Nicely done. 5-5. All square here. It's 5-5. Australia with the possession. Perhaps haven't had the success they would have hoped for in the senior levels. The Japanese women's water polo team only down in 14th place at home at the recent FINA World Aquatics in Fukuoka. Water polo competition finishing just on the eve of these games. That could be crucial. Camilla McKay sends that ball home. Inaba beaten all ends up. Australia trying to pick out the shooting chance. There might be one here. Couple of feints and a finish. And the two-goal cushion now for the bronze. Just 2:30 to go. Calm your jets, says Coach Nicholson. But they're close now. They really are. Yeah, all hands to the pump now, as far as the Japanese are concerned. Great defence again. Absolutely superb. So Inaba, she can't afford to delay. That's through the middle. It's Yamamoto. Quick switch inside to Kobayashi. Worked it to Takahashi, and Yamamoto blocked off in the middle. This is nervy now for Australia, because we're going to have a 5-metre penalty. 46 seconds to play. It's Fujiwara versus Pamp. Oh, she's found it. She's found the corner. 7-6. Drama at the end of the bronze medal matchup. There's going to have to be one more turnover. 12, 11, 10. The bronze medal will be heading to Australia. And Pamp just runs down the clock. We're going to hear the buzzer. They don't need the cushion of the eighth goal. Australia have a medal at the end of the women's water polo. Look how much it means. They are on the podium and the traditional coaches dunk. Australia beating Japan just 7-6 for third place. A fitting introduction then to what promises to be a thrilling climax to the women's water polo here at the Chengdu World University Summer Games. So, 7v7 in the water, the start of the first of our quarters here. Who's going to win the swim-off? It's a sprint finish, and already there's a big scramble. So, attacking foul committed by Chiara Rinaldi, who hit 7 goals in the semi-final routing of the Japanese. She's going to be huge here as that whole set player, just rotating with the centre forward there, deep through that perimeter on the edge of the 2-metre line. But it's China on the offensive straight away. Yansiar there, point player. So pressure in the early stages here at 32nd. The shot clock ticking down to almost 5 seconds here. It's going to have to be a reset and come backwards as China score the opening goal. And it took just 28 seconds of this gold medal matchup. Sharp shooting, Lu Yiwen with her 15th goal of the tournament. just trying to edge closer. And that's the equaliser. Repetto. First time they got in an offensive situation here. Very slow there, that Chinese defensive wall to close down Anna Repetto. Yan Xia switches it. So right on the edge at present, and might be given the chance here to go high. No, faints. It goes left, and they pretty much swim it in. That was Lu Yi Wen, making it 2-1 here. A really bright star while they were toying with Italy. It came through Wang Xiyun, and then finally finished. Again, she looks for that driver. This is the right-sided attack from Carosi. Nardini. Two-one China, scratch that, it's 2-2. Again, they backed off. Not enough protection there for Dong Wenxin. And Carlotta Meggiato of the University of Padua levels up this gold medal contest. It's really strong handling from the Chinese. It's been a feature the whole way through, and there always seems to be room with the option players as well. One touch, and that's pushed over the line brilliantly by Chen Xiao. It's end to end here, and China hit back. No sooner really does Meggiato equalize than the team in red just flood the opposition, score again themselves. Here comes the counter-attack. Oh, that's a cute finish. It's in off the upright. Lu Yi Wen has fed it across. Delightful finish that. She found that gap. But for Lu Yi Wen, around the outside once more. Like basketball, around the edge of the two-point zone. And finally, from that left side, it's a fifth goal in this final. And the top scorer in this tournament for the Chinese opens their account in the final match of it. Good stuff from China. They're in control here of this gold medal matchup, 5-2. Second quarter swim off. China, three goal cushion here in the gold medal matchup against the Italians. The gap is three. Yeah, possession. A little bit wasteful there from Italy. It's always dangerous against China. Jiang Jin moving the ball forward with such fluidity. Across it comes, Acella comes out. Oh, how did that happen? I can't believe it. What a sweep there from Lu Yi Wen. And absolutely no right to finish that, but finish it she did. So this is the ball. Two Italians look to have covered that. How on earth did she extend that arm telescopically? And Lu Yi Wen, two-on-one play. That's just too good. Foul call against Rinaldi, and that backhand play, Chen Xiao. Valeria Uccella's net is bulging again, and China really beginning to stretch their legs in this final. That's a bullet on the reverse side there from Chen Xiao. Post. Repetto trying the shot that time. It's good play actually from Meggiato, who just committed the defender, or forced the defender to commit, to give the angle for the shot and the passage through. But those shots have to be landing. They have to be going in really. if Italy are to have a chance here. Once again, it's a real wrestle in the water. Biding a time before shooting. No, instead the responsibility passes right side to Zhang Jin. And China have another. And they're really beginning to extend in this gold medal matchup now. Patrick, goal for Zhang Jin. 8-2 is the score. All going to plan for China. And that's one back for Italy. A top corner shot. High and nice there from Rinaldi. He's absolutely pulling the trigger here. Oh, yes. Meggiato. Bit of elevation on that. That's nicely worked and tidily finished as well by Sara Kudavani. That's the end product that they need here. This was a cute move. Lovely take by Nardini. Zhang Jing with the hat-trick that is inspiring China at the moment. They lead by 8-4 at half-time. Lift to the side, keeping it out of the water here, the Italians. Nardini, it came all the way around to Di Claudio. They were just jockeying it, and then the offload to Rinaldi. Just trying to probe and prod and see who had the best angle and the best route through. Possession now for Italy. Vercello drops that short. Point player in this attack will be Carosi. Nardini for Carosi. They're trying the same move again, but the quality of the shooting all round has to be right on it here. Nardini has dumped that into the near post, and that rebound from Gagliardi just rolls it over the line. Italy on the march here. China's lead cut down now to 2 goals. That's more like it, more positive. Defensive foul called. Looks like there's an exclusion as well. Power play here for China. 6v5. An extra number and an extra goal to boot as well. Yan Xiao. Well, that's why you have to be so, so careful about making fouls in those defensive zones, because Italy were short-handed there. So it's extra work for all the players in the pool to be doing. So the last 15 of the shot clock. Oh, beautifully done. Picking their way through to perfection. The quality of the passing and the movement, the handling, and finally the shooting. It's a lovely little nudge inside there to Chen Xiao. 10-6. Normal service resumed here. Every possession phase has to count against China in this mood. This is Yan Xiao. Oh! How has she fed that through? It was played all the way across to the right side driver. And that's a really sharp finish from Wang Huan. It's a no-look pass, isn't it, from Nong Sanfeng. It's looking very much now like the Chinese will be winning their 3rd gold medal in women's water polo. Left-sided drive there, set up by Uccello, the goalkeeper. 4:30 to play in this final. Italy with 5 goals to make up. Nesti. It's
switch it to left side, whole setting there into Cordovani. She's fouled. So round they come again. It's Repetto. There's no way through there, but who's the option? The answer is Nesty. So Nesty switches it. That's a bouncer from Cordovani. On the rebounds, nothing. Italy possession on the reset, a 20-second reset here with Uccella. So it's going to be all Italy. This possession has to work. And inside the final 2 minutes now. Swing chance for Cordovani. They're edging closer. It's Repetto. It's Cordovani. It's slung wide for Nardini. One back here, so that makes it 11-7. Little bit tighter, but still the four-goal gap. Take nothing away from that finish, which is slung at the near post past Dong. But China, with the immediate possession and the chance to restore the cushion straight away, 2-5 goals. Their finishing has been superb all match long. Although things did get a little bit ragged here in this final 8 minutes. They won't care about that. They won't even remember when that final buzzer goes to signify the gold. It's Yancy. Ah, lovely cross to that far side. And that lift into the net seals the deal. Delightful. Well, they've made use of that. The lofted pass to the blind side. Keeper taken out of the game. Belgrade 2009, Shenzhen 2011. And at home again in Chengdu, China. Women's water polo golden girls once more at the World University Summer Games. It's a second straight silver for the Italians. Defeated at home in Napoli 4 years ago when they were the host nation. Defeated by the home country here in China. It was comfortable in the end by 5 goals, 12-7. They defeated the Italians in the final showdown. Confirmation then of the medals in the women's water polo competition. Australia bronze, Italy silver, another gold for China.